Ladies and gentlemen, will you now please welcome the Utah youth to the field.
Good afternoon and welcome to Witter Rugby Field in beautiful Berkeley, California. I'm your host, Keegan Engelbrecht, bringing you all the action in today's match between the University of California Golden Bears and the University of Utah Utes. Cal remains undefeated in 2023, most recently coming off a 50-13 conference victory over UCLA at home last weekend. Eight different Bears notched eight tries with Max Schumacher and Keelan O'Connell combining to convert on five of those tries. Three scores came from a trio of freshman starters, Max Threlkeld, Ran Santos, who will be featuring today, and Solomon Williams. The result marked Jack Clark's milestone 700th win in 15's competition as head coach at Cal. University of Utah fly half Ian Warmer will get things going in today's match here once we get the go-ahead from referee Steve Finneroli. Warmer opting to move the ball to the right-hand side, neatly gathered by Cal number 8, Alex Aguero. Caleb Thomasine moving the ball away from the ruck into his captain, blindside flaker, John Puckett. Thomasine now into fly half Keelan O'Connell. Bears putting the ball nicely through their hands, finding an overlap down the right side early here in this match. Strong carry by speedster Joe Kirsten as Cal finds their way into Utah territory. Thomasine again finding one of his locks, Tom Dixon. Bears moving the ball to the short side here through prop Josh Mao. One of 12 changes in today's lineup for Cal.
Mac, Green, Mac, Green, Mac, Green, 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 Green,
Mac Fell finding his way into the defense, keeping his hands free, moving the ball left. Unfortunately blown up by referee Steve Finneroli. Looks to be a forward pass by the Bears, which will bring us to today's first scrum. I mentioned 12 changes from last week's contest against UCLA for the Bears. Forward pack with Josh Mau, Matt Vranish, and Charlie Walsh getting his first start in 2023, returning from injury. Second row pairing of Tom Dixon and John Puckett with Cal Leibowitz, Alex Aguero making up the back row. Excuse me, Hugo Schroeder, the other lock there. Again, earning his first meaningful start as the Bears have a strong push over the Utah Utes. Hugo Schroeder, the sophomore from Australia, earning his first start today, featured in the game against Santa Barbara about 3 weeks ago. He'll be excited to feature strongly here in front of a home crowd in Berkeley. Utah fly off even warmer, putting the ball high to the left side of the field. Gathered easily by Joe Kirsten, who shrugs off a few defenders, but knocks the ball on in the tackle. Referee playing advantage. Cal looks to turn the ball over here and recycling the ruck in the 5 meter line on the right hand side, just inside the 22. And earning a penalty from that ruck, looks to be potentially offsides. We'll see what Cal opts for here today. Opportunity here to kick for 3 points or put the ball deep into Utah territory for a lineout. And that's what Fly Half O'Connell opts for. First lineout of the day here for the Bears with junior Matt Vranish with the throw in. Finds his jumper, Tom Dixon, well. Utah opting not to contest the maul, so Josh Mau carries hard. Only a couple of meters out from the try zone. Utah withstanding that pressure very well, earning themselves a penalty. Holding on in the ruck. Good opportunity for them to clear their lines. Utah bringing a young team to Berkeley this afternoon. Ian Tapuilulu, Spencer Hoon, and Sam Belcher, notably called out by the head coach for today. Drew McDaniel, Sami Bushnak in the second row with Peyton Fontaine, Ethan Churn, and Captain Jake Kinevac as the eighth man rounding out their forward pack. Utah moving the ball into midfield off of their lineout. As scrum half Hennaro Fiorello moves the ball to his fly half, trying again to relieve pressure. Oliver Newell steady under the high ball and carries just over halfway. Mac Fell finding an opportunity here, pick and jam from the ruck. Nothing but the try line in front of him, moving the ball left to his speedster, Alex Brundage, who's over the try line to open up the scoring for the Bears. Picking up 5 points, 5 minutes gone in today's contest. Senior Alex Brundage, the Canadian, picking up his second try for the season, first for today. Really good run of play there from the Bears. Doing well to withstand the attack from lineout from Utah. Turning the ball over. Center Mac Fell picking up from the ruck, opting for some space down the short side. As fly half Keelan O'Connell will look to add two more. O'Connell having an excellent season at goal so far, converting 17 of 19 conversions so far this season. 89% success rate for the sophomore from San Francisco. A difficult kick for O'Connell with no problem whatsoever. Adding two more, bringing the score 7-0 for the Bears. Freshman Ian Warmer will get us restarted. Squirrely kick from the freshman, kicking the ball deep into Cal territory. They'll let it roll over the try line, dotting the ball down. Cal moving in earnest back to midfield. Looks like they're shaping for a scrum center. Really good attacking platform here for the Bears. Plenty of options to move the ball left or right. I mentioned a young team from Utah. Hanara Fiorello, the scrum half. Ian Warmer, the fly half. Center pairing of Logan Shannon and Garrett Walker with Ethan Ogzwala, Alex Smith, and Will Koth rounding out the deep three for the Utes. Thomasine moving right from the scrum center. Alex Aguero finding a scrum half Thomasine. Thomasine through some quick hands from Oliver Newell. Joe Kirsten again, shedding off any defenders that come through him. Finally gathered as he crosses the 22. Thomasine into Mao. Good hands from the front rowers. Matt Vranish into Alex Brundage again down the left-hand side for his second of the day in 3 minutes. Excellent skills there from the Bears. Really great scrum center. Strong attacking platform, finding their way behind the defense down the right side. Recycling the ball quickly through multiple sets of hands. All skills, all players, as preached here from head coach Jack Clark. Alex Brundage does his job. Cleans up some very good skill, crossing over the line for his second of the day. The San Franciscan Keelan O'Connell again converting, adding two more, bringing our score 14-0. Just past 9 minutes gone here in the first half. In speaking with the Utah head coach before today's contest, he shared their goal today really is just to play to their standards, to stay sharp. They've had kind of mixed success so far in their 15s campaign. Heightened focus on bringing the physicality battle to the Bears today, as well as when they can playing the territory game. As play gets restarted, Tom Dixon gathering the restart and taking it into contact, but it seems Bears were off their feet at that ruck for a penalty infringement from referee Steve Finneroli. We'll see what the Utah Utes opt to do here. Going for the penalty here for 3 points. From freshman Ian Warmer. Beautiful today here in Berkeley. We can see the red from the San Francisco Golden Gate, a slight breeze blowing in from the west. We'll see if Warmer t- takes that breeze into his calculations. Does well to judge the wind. Knocks the ball over, the flags go up. Picking up 3 points for Utah here. As Cal will look to get us restarted through fly half Keelan O'Connell. Great restart, high and short for the Bears. Gathered by Utah, but tackled hard by Tom Dixon. Fly half warmer, does well to get that ball off of his foot. Good attacking option here from Oliver Newell, the fullback for the Bears. Running hard just over the 22 is Thomasine, digging to recycle. O'Connell into Rand Santos, his outside center. Doing well to step left and right, beating all of the defenders. Excellent counterattack from the Bears as Rand finds his way to the try line to pick up the third try for the Bears today. Oliver Newell, the fullback for the Bears out of London, does an excellent job of taking that ball in step, attacking hard, recycling quickly, and then Rand Santos cleans it up. Rand Santos, of course, the freshman from Manila. His dad, Rick, played football and rugby at Cal, graduated in 1998. Continued a long line of rugby success after leaving Cal, playing for the London Harlequins, University of Oxford, and of course the Olympic Club in San Francisco. Again, the flags going up for O'Connell, as they so often do when he's kicking from tee, making him 3 from 3 for the afternoon. 21-3 in favor of the Bears. In warm-ups, Warmer shaping left and right options, this time using his right foot to kick the ball to the left. Joe Kirsten, the South African, finds his center, Mac Fell, to carry into midfield. And again, referee Steve Finneroli blowing it up for what looks to be a knock-on in the tackle. Scrum down for Utah. Head coach Jack Clark earning his 700th victory against UCLA last weekend here in the 40th season of him at the helm for the Bears. The good push from Cal. Good movement off the right-hand side. Strong tackle from Rand Santos. With Bears doing well to earn themselves a penalty, holding on at the tackle. Thomasine wanting to go quick, finds his center, Big Mac Fell, who's met hard by Ian Tapuilulu. Thomasine again probing around the ruck. Cal losing their shape a bit there in that sequence, resulting in a knock-on. Another attacking scrum for Utah. Ute scrum half, Fiorello with the put in. Picked by captain Jake Kinevac. Taken into the tackle. Unclear what the signal is from referee Finneroli. But the result here will be a scrum down for Cal. Significant short side for the Bears here. We'll see if they opt to go for the short side from this attacking scrum or release their back line. Thomasine moving right. Aguero picking and going right, beating his first defender. Bit of miscommunication there from that forward pack, but resulting in a strong carry from Tom Dixon. Keeps the ball alive off of the ground. Finds his prop, Josh Mao. O'Connell to Santos. Santos finds Newell. Newell with a strong run, trying to keep the ball alive. Looks to be okay from referee Finneroli. Instead, opts to blow his whistle after what looked to be a try scored. Looks like that offload from Oliver Newell did, in fact, go forward. Another attacking scrum now for Utah, deep in their own end. Fly half warmer, I'm sure, will want to clear his lines with a kick. I think a blood sub for the Utah Utes. Open side flanker Ethan Churn running to the sideline to be cleaned up. Now that the sub has been sorted, we'll get restarted with play. Referee Finneroli doesn't like what he sees, the gap between the two front rowers.
Eyes up, Jay. Big scrum, boys. John, head up, here we go.
Fiorello with the put in, moving the ball to his fly half. Ian Warmer charged down by Thomasine. Messy ball for Brundage, but does well to gather. Beating a number of defenders with his feet. Finds some space into Ran Santos. Keeps the ball alive to Joe Kirsten, the South African, again dancing and carrying the ball well into the contact area. Thomasine flattened at the ruck. But a very strong carry from John Puckett. Bouncing a number of defenders. Cal bringing the ball back to the open side. O'Connell will carry the ball hard into the contest area, running over Will Koth. Bears about 6 meters out. Josh Mao will tidy things up around the ruck. Thomasine. Through O'Connell, Santos shows and goes and over for the easy score with Grant Santos picking up his second try for the day. Good patience from the Bears in that sequence. A number of players touching the ball, a number of players urgent to resource the ball at the ruck. And then, of course, the skills to put the ball through their hands and put the defense under a tremendous amount of pressure with Santos with a little show and go to find his second try. O'Connell again will add the extras. And does so, splitting the uprights, making him 4 from 4 for the afternoon. Bringing our score 28-3, 20 minutes gone in this first half. Utah visits Strawberry Canyon this weekend with a 4-2 record in Spring 15's play. The Utes opened their season at the Dennis Storer Classic at UCLA, where they went 2-1, down San Diego State in a regular season opener, handing the Aztecs a 57-5 defeat. then fell 5-95 against Arizona in Tucson on February 4th. Last week in 43-0 shutout against Air Force in their home opener, as Finneroli earns or indicates a penalty for the Bears. Looking like O'Connell will attempt a touch finder, getting the ball deep, kicking it directly at our tower this afternoon. Junior Matt Vranish returning to the starting lineup this weekend. One of 12 changes for the Bears from last weekend's game against UCLA. Down to Thomasine, to O'Connell, Mac Fell. Through his hands to Rand Santos, finding a ton of space, 3-on-1, beats his first defender. Showing plenty of pace, unfortunately running into touch. Utah doing well to withstand the attacking threat of Santos, Joe Kirsten, Alex Brundage, of course, on the left wing. Strong counterattack so far that we've seen from fullback Oliver Newell. Bears fielding a mixed side this weekend. I mentioned 12 changes from last weekend. A number of Bears returning to the starting lineup. Notably, Hugo Schroeder earning his first start this afternoon as the Bears work to be just 1 meter out from the Utah try line. With a try signaled from referee Finneroli, that looks to be Cal Leibowitz dotting down this afternoon's captain for the Bears.
Try, California.
Leibowitz, the senior from Danville, local Bay Area boy. With the try being right of the uprights, a more difficult kick for Keelan O'Connell, being a right-footed striker. Does have the wind helping him. Looks like he likes it. Unfortunately, the flags do stay down, leaving his tally today 4 from 5. Correction, that was Matt Vranish with the try, not Cal Leibowitz. Utah doing an excellent job to regather their restart. Be a strong carry from the front rower for Utah. Although Bears turning the ball over. But a penalty indicated from referee Finneroli, not rolling away. Utah opted for 3 points when they were last in this position. Instead, moving forward with a lineout, about 5 meters in the Cal 22. Sophomore Spencer Hoon, the hooker, from Holiday, Utah, with the throw-in for the Utes. Good throw from Hoon, down neatly from Utah, using Garrett Walker to carry the ball into the defense. Warmer now to his other center, Logan Shannon, with, again, a strong carry inside the 22 for Utah. Good tackle in from the Bears, resulting in a turbo. Thomasine into his fly half, O'Connell. What? Thomasine now to O'Connell. O'Connell into MacPhail. MacPhail finding Santos. Santos again opting to tuck and step. Earns his way past the 50-meter line. Tom Dixon again with another carry. Thomasine to O'Connell. Now Alex Aguero, the eighth man for Cal. Cal doing well to string some phases here. Plenty of numbers down the right-hand side for the Bears. Cal Leibowitz, the overside flanker. And Joe Kirsten again carrying it into Utah territory. Josh Mao now, the junior. O'Connell to MacPhail at the back. Seeing if his wing Brundage can find a way through the Utah defense. Leibowitz doing well to withstand the first contact. Recycling quickly. Oliver Newell finding some space. Brought down at the 5-meter line. Quick burst from referee Finneroli. Perhaps for a repeated infringement by Utah. Referee Finneroli speaking with the Utah captain, Jake Kinovac. Always dangerous to commit penalties this deep in your own territory. Too many will often result in a yellow card, repeated infringement, professional foul. Bears selecting a scrum center in the shadow of their goalposts. Excuse me, of Utah's goalposts. A great attacking option here for the Bears. Opportunities to move the ball left and right. Cal's Thomasine with the put in. Short arm penalty from Finneroli. Thomasine going quickly. Looks to be over the try line for another try for the Bears. Five more points. Caleb Thomasine, the junior, doing a great job to stay on the boil at the time of the whistle there from the referee. Catching the Utah Utes off guard. Earning his first try for the day, second of the season. Thomasine, of course, the younger brother of Stephen Thomasine, the U.S. National Sevens player. As O'Connell will add two more, bringing the score 40-3 in favor of the Bears, about 11 minutes left in this first half. Warmer this time, restarting deep right into Bears territory. Collected and returned with interest via a spiral bomb from Alex Brundage. Strong chase from Brundage, putting the Utes under pressure. Doing a great job from their fullback, Will Koth, to clear his lines. Gets the ball over halfway. Relieving a tremendous amount of pressure from Utah. Matt Vranish will get us started via his second rower, Tom Dixon. O'Connell now into his blindside flanker, Puckett, with a good carry over halfway. Thomasine recycles quickly. O'Connell finding the defense up in his face, opts to keep it. shuck some defenders. Certainly a high tackle from Utah. Tempers flaring. 10-on-10 there, of course. O'Connell tackled high by his opposite number, Ian Warmer. No ill intent, just managed to catch him high. O'Connell looks like he'll kick the ball deep into the Utah zone. For another Cal lineout, does so. About 10 meters out from the try line. Matt Vranish, the De La Salle grad, with the throw-in for the Bears. Bears bringing the ball down neatly from Tom Dixon, the Texan. Shaping for a maul. And now going to work around the ruck. Thomasine's going to release his back line. O'Connell finds MacFell. Another strong carry from the Australian. Dotting the ball down dead center for the Bears.
California.
MacFell, his first try of the day and of this 15s campaign. Bringing our score 45-3 in favor for the Bears. With O'Connell still to add the extras. Of course he does so.
California.
Hard to get a conversion easier than that for O'Connell. Dotted down directly in the shadow of the goalpost. 6 from 7 so far today for O'Connell. About 7 minutes remain in this first half. Deep kick from Wormer. Calmly collected by O'Connell with a strong clearing kick. A significant territory change there from O'Connell, the sophomore. Doing a great job to calmly gather the kick, get his feet underneath him, and execute. Ethan Churn, the open side flanker with the throw-in for Utah. Tom Dixon does well to disrupt that line-out. Alex Aguero gathers Cal Leibowitz into his hooker, Matt Vranish. Thomasine to O'Connell, to Fell. Neat ball out from Fell. Santos into some space. We'll see if Joe Kirsten can maintain his pace, beats the first defender and the second. Speed and step from the South African Joe Kirsten out of Cape Town, South Africa. The Bishop's boy earning his first try of the afternoon, his 5th of the season so far. Very tidy interplay from the Bears there, doing well to overturn the ball. At the line of touch, moving the ball quickly through multiple sets of hands. Kirsten beating, I think, 3 defenders before finding the try line. And O'Connell will add 2 more.
O'Connell, California.
54-3 here this first half in favor of Cal. And speaking with head coach Jack Clark, the focus today for this group was on systems, on execution, and effort, playing with energy as they continue to build for this 15th campaign with Warmer getting us restarted. Joe Kirsten into his scrum half, Thomasine. Strong running from Caleb Thomasine. Newell will move the ball from the ruck. As Aguero beats his first defender, finds himself into some space. Unfortunately alone, may not need any support whatsoever and does not with two strong steps and a right-hand fend over Will Koth, although blown up by the referee. Unsure what the infringement is. Looks to be brought back by his AR, Roberto Santiago, back at Cal's 10-meter line. Perhaps an infringement at that ruck from Thomasine carrying it in. Referee Finneroli having a word with Utah captain Jake Kinevac, with a yellow card being shown to Gennaro Fiorello. And the try awarded for the Bears.
Aguero, California.
An athletic run from Alex Aguero, the senior from Marin County here in the North Bay area, beating two defenders with his feet, fending the third to dot down, resulting in another challenging kick for Keelan O'Connell here. Just over 2 minutes remain in this first half. O'Connell pushing it just right across the face of the uprights, leaving 2 points wanting, 59-3 with about a minute and a half left in the first half action. That being the third try for Aguero this season, as Warmer gets us restarted. Moving the ball left this time. Done well by Cal Leibowitz. Penalty awarded to the Utes, holding on by Cal, both Leibowitz and the Bears. This time Utah opting for an attempt at three more points before the halftime whistle. I think if you're Utah, there's an opportunity for points on the board. Might as well take them. Fly half Warmer likes his chances. Captain Jake Kinevac backing his fly half. And the option to go to goal. Good strike from Warmer. That's three more points for Utah. And that's the halftime whistle from Stephen Finneroli. Score is 59-6 in favor of Cal. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with second half action here from Witter Rugby Field in Berkeley.
You can follow Cal Varsity Rugby on social media. Go to @CalVarsityRugby to follow the Golden Bears on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And fans, the Bears will return to Witter Rugby Field on Saturday, February 25th, when they host the Arizona Wildcats in a homecoming celebration. Coming to the match for the Golden Bears, number 21, McCall, the beer for number 13, Rand Santos. Also coming in, number 18, Brett Dogowitz for number 8, Alex Guerrero.
Welcome back, rugby fans. It's a clear February afternoon at the University of California, Berkeley, with second half action at Witter Rugby Field. Bears in the lead 59-6, seven different Bears dotting down nine tries. Keelan O'Connell going 7 from 9 for conversions as he gets things restarted here. Ian Warmer with a left footed strike to clear his lines. Couple of changes for the Bears at halftime. Mikael De Beer, the freshman from Johannesburg, South Africa, for Rand Santos, the outside center, and Brett Dogowitz has joined the action for, I believe, a second rower. I'll get that confirmation. Thomasine now to O'Connell, dumps the ball into Mac Fell, causing all sorts of trouble for the Utah defense as Mac Fell picks up his second try of the afternoon, second of the season, with 90 seconds gone in this first half. O'Connell adds two more. Kicking at 80% is O'Connell today, 8 from 10, with our score 66-6 in favor of the Bears. Warmer keeping things interesting, this time opting for a deep kick to the right side of the field. The ball sitting up just before the try line, gathered by Brett Dogowitz. Keeps the ball alive. The strong carry from Miles Malone, who's also joined the action. As the ball is put through DeBeer's hands, finds Oliver Newell. Joe Kirsten with the switch back inside. With Newell cleaning things up. And Bears earning a penalty for their efforts just inside the 22. Miles Malone in the 19 shirt, taking place of Tom Dixon. His afternoon is done. Another strong performance from the Texan. The Woodlands, Texas, just outside of Houston. Bears get things restarted from a lineout. Unclear on the infringement, but looks to be another line out now for Utah. Turnover from Cal. Josh Mao with the turnover. Thomasine will get things going from his front rower, Charlie Walsh. Of course, returning to action today for the first time this season. A neat ball from O'Connell dumped into Joe Kirsten, finding a gap in the defense.
California.
For his second try of the afternoon. The South African doing well to come off his wing, look for work, find an opportunity to split the defense. Another easy kick for O'Connell to add two more, and does so, bringing our score 73-6. 4.5 minutes gone in this second half. Joe Kirsten picking up two so far this afternoon, bringing his season tally to 6 tries in the 15s code for the Bears. Fullback Newell with time under the restart. Opting to keep the ball and go himself. Find some space down the right touchline. Well resourced by Cal. Thundering carry from John Puckett, the blindside flanker for the Bears, beating multiple defenders. Good support from the replacement, Dogowitz. Now Mao into his fly half. Space for Mac Fell. Options abound. Opts to move the ball into Alex Brundage. All skills, all players, from front rower Charlie Walsh finds himself on the wing down the left-hand touchline. An excellent job to add 5 more points for the Bears from Charlie Walsh. A nice welcome for Walsh returning to action today for the Bears. Charlie, of course, a brother of Sam Walsh, Cal rugby grad last year, now spending his time with the U.S. Sevens national team in Southern California. O'Connell now kicking into the wind in this second half. A great strike. Unfortunately, fades across the face of the uprights. More changes now for the Bears. Matt Vranish and Charlie Walsh. Their afternoons are over. Ian Warmer with a deep kick. I don't think that's going to stop. It does not, so that restart will be kicked dead. Bring us back for a scrum down at center field.
Coming in for the Golden Bears, number 16, Kay Chris. For number 12, Matt Branish. Also coming in, number 17, Clayton Seastrand. For number 3, Charlie Walsh.
Cade Crist replacing Matt Vranish at hooker. Clayton Seastrand in the 17 shirt replacing Charlie Walsh, the try scorer, in the front row. Caleb Thomasine, the scrum half, will get things restarted for the Bears. Scrum down at center field. Bears moving the ball left off of the scrum this time. Skill breakdown in center field between Thomasine and Mac Fell, the Australian. Bit of indecision there, miscommunication.
Next job back, head up, let's go. Let's get a launch here.
Plenty of opportunity in a game like today for some of the younger Bears to earn some experience in 15's action. Opportunities like that certainly don't come too often. So a good opportunity for these younger Bears to step up. Short arm penalty awarded to the Bears. Caleb Thomasine with the quick tap, finding his center Mac Fell with a strong carry into contact. Numbers left and right for the Bears. Reversing the run of play, Thomasine into Josh Mao, his front rower. O'Connell now with an overlap, numbers down the left-hand side. Alex Brundage keeping the ball alive and in play. Into the blindside flanker, John Puckett. Ball cleaned up by Fell. Thomasine to O'Connell. Fumbled by DeBeer, although it looked like the Utah Utes were offside from that previous ruck, which will explain the pressure in front of DeBeer's face. Thomasine sees some space to the left. Numbers and an overlap for the Bears. Mac Fell keeps it, tucks it, finds the try line, does Mac Fell for his third of the afternoon, earning himself a hat trick. No stranger to the try line this afternoon is Mac Fell. Doing well in open play with his strong carries. Finding space when it counts, beating defenders. An opportunity for Keelan O'Connell, the San Franciscan, to add two more. Flags again go up for O'Connell. 85-6. California over the Utes. Little under a half hour of play remain in this second half. High restart from Warmer. Kirsten probing, finding a soft shoulder in the Utah defense. Cal moving the ball to the short side via Oliver Newell, the fullback. An untidy ruck resulting in a turnover for the Utes. Sam Belcher carrying the ball for the Utah. Ultimately turning it over in contact, cleaned up by Dogowitz. And O'Connell finding some space, putting a tidy ball behind the Utah defense, and fullback Koth under a tremendous amount of pressure. O'Connell again spotting some space. That will roll deep into touch. He looked to be in his own half. The ball looked to go out of bounds beyond the 22. We'll see if the referees agree for a 50-22. Of course, one of the new law changes this season. Cal unfortunate not to earn that. Some pretty clever play from O'Connell. Ball must have gone out of bounds just before the 22. Utah now with a lineout. Peyton Fontaine jumping for Utah. Turned over by the Bears via Hugo Schroeder. the sophomore from Brisbane. And the open side, Cal Leibowitz with a strong carry. Today's a captain. O'Connell now, MacPhail at the back, into Newell. Quick hands from Newell. Kirsten does well to maintain. Oh, dives for the line. Another forward pass, as determined by the referee. Really tidy hands from the Bears. Opportunity gone wanting for the Bears. We'll see if Utah is able to work their way out of their own half. Warmer clears his lines with a spiral bomb deep into Cal territory. Kirsten working back with Newell to regather. A 2v2. Kirsten opting to take the ball into contact. MacPhail will recycle the ball into replacement hooker Cade Crist. Thomasine to O'Connell. Finds a ball inside to Dogowitz. And Utah with yet another infringement at the breakdown. Steady breeze into O'Connell's face now, coming out of the west. First throw in for Cade Crist, the replacement hooker. Crist from Torrey Pines, California. Pins his jumper. Good hands from the Bears. Newell again finding some space down the left side. Hard left step. Turns on the afterburners. Leaves the Utes behind him. Newell earning his first try of the afternoon. And second of the season.
Newell, California.
The freshman from the Harrow School in London. An educated left step there. Does well to beat the defense. Spots some space, turns on his speed. Nothing in front of him but the try line. Brings our score 90-6, pending the conversion from O'Connell. Pushing the ball to the right. An uncharacteristic miss from O'Connell. Let's go, 22 minutes remain in this afternoon's action. Utah doing well on the physical side, finding some opportunities for some big tackles, but just unable to keep up with the speed and pace of play from the Bears this afternoon. Deep left kick from Wormer. May have overcooked it. Does so. Which will result in a scrum midfield for the Bears. Plenty of changes for the Bears in their pack. Josh Mao still in the number one shirt. Cade Crist and Clayton Seastrand, the replacements. Miles Malone for Tom Dixon. Brett Dogowitz for Alex Guerrero. Thomasine will put it in. Dogowitz has it at his feet, opting to move the ball to the right. Thomasine to Newell. Newell does well to pin and pass. Kept alive by Kirsten's right boot. Charged down by Kirsten. The kick from Will Koth. Although blown up by referee Finneroli. Ian Wermer will try and relieve some pressure for his side, failing to find touch. Ball moved infield. Kirsten, Newell into Connell. Full complement of backline here. Fell. Strong carry from DeBeer. Thomasine unleashing his forward pack via Dogowitz. Thomasine again to O'Connell. Into Schroeder. The Australian stays alive. Thomasine reversing play via Josh Mao, the black belt. MacPhail now to DeBeer. Pins and passes, an easy try for Brundage. Good hands from the Bears, good sequence of play. Good interplay from forwards and backs. More changes now for the Bears. John Puckett's afternoon is over, the blindside flanker. O'Connell, another challenging kick. Certainly the easier of the two angles, the left touchline, for a right-footed striker. Looks good. The flags go up for Connell for yet another conversion.
California.
That being O'Connell's final act for today, conversion from the left touchline, replaced by Jack Casey. Dom Paga also in on the action for John Puckett. Brundage with a kick across the face, failed to gather by Utah Ethan Churn, turned over in contact. Leibowitz again cleaning things up. Schroeder through his hands. MacPhail, as he's done so often this afternoon, tidying things up. Although referee Stephen Finneroli sees something he doesn't like. The short burst. Having a conversation with fly half Ian Wermer. Showing a yellow card to front rower Sam Belcher. Looks to be a resulting yellow card, a result of a high tackle. Drew McDaniel for Utah. Off as well, been replaced as Caleb Thomasine gets things restarted through MacPhail. Here goes Jack Casey, the replacement fly half. First touch of the ball, I think. Finds his way through the defense. A good left-hand fend. Dots down in the right corner for the Bears. That try from Casey brings the score to 102-6. Little over a quarter of hour left in today's action. As Jack Casey will attempt to convert his own try. Right-hand touchline for a right-handed kicker. Breeze in his face, certainly not an easy one. keeping the ball low out of the breeze just across the face of the uprights. No changes to the score. Tough afternoon for the Utes. Wanted to play territory, wanted to play to their standards. Certainly bringing the physicality, I think, just unable to keep up with the pace of play from the Bears. Worma opting to go to the right side. Collected by Dogowitz. Thomasine now. Miles Malone finds his way through the Utah defense. Bringing possession over halfway. I think a high clear out by the Bears at that previous ruck. Spotted by the AR, earning Utah a penalty. Warmer will want to find touch and does so. Opportunity for an attacking lineout for Utah. Open side flanker, Ethan Churn, the senior from Charlotte, North Carolina, with the throw-in. Final confirmation of the calls as they approach the line of touch. Utah maintains possession at the line of touch. Although tackled into touch by the Bears, ball is kept alive. Thomasine now on the attack. Clever hands from Cal, although another whistle from referee Finneroli. High tackle by the Bears. Warmer likely opting for another kick to touch. Utes with a line out just inside the Cal 22. Bears doing a good job of disrupting their line out, doing so again, but maintaining possession. Warmer now into some movement in the centers. Finneroli again seeing something that he doesn't like. Some changes for Utah in the centers. Looks to be a replacement inside center. Garrett Walker afternoon is over. As the Bears turn over the ball at the line of touch. Dogowitz to Casey. Casey finding some space. De Beer to his South African partner Kirsten down the right-hand side. The South African connection is alive and well at Cal. De Beer to Joe Kirsten. Down the right touchline. Kirsten earning his third of the afternoon for a hat trick for Cal. Replacement fly half Jack Casey with a virtually identical attempt at goal from his previous spot. De Beer joining the Bears from Johannesburg, South Africa, where he was at Hilton College. We'll see if Jack Casey's able to right the wrong from his previous attempt. It's a better shaped kick, again, still fading across the face of the uprights for Casey. Our score this afternoon, 107-6 so far, with about 11 minutes remaining. Second half action. Josh Mao, his afternoon is over. Strong performance for Mao, earning his way into the starting lineup this week. Newell calm under the high ball. Uses left boot to clear his lines. Opts to keep the ball into touch. And a good chase from Newell. Kicked ahead by Newell. Unfortunately suffering from the unpredictable bounce of the rugby ball as the ball dribbles into touch. Utah's churn with the throw in, deep in their own end. Cal does well to disrupt the line out again. Ball stays alive. Although an infringement from the Bears, letting Utah off the hook. Opportunity for Warmer to clear his lines. Alleviate some pressure. Does so. Picks up about 15 or so meters for a line out just inside the 22 for Utah. Cal staying consistent in their ability to disrupt the Utah lineout. Utah gathered up by number 14, Alex Smith, keeping the ball tight. Looks to be an offsides infringement by the Bears. Another opportunity for Warmer to get his team out of his own end. Much better kick this time for a lineout here just past the 10-meter line. Hugo Schroeder missing the opportunity for turnover, but doing well to disrupt, unfortunately resulting in a knock-on by Bears. Referee Stephen Finneroli awarding a scrum for the Utes. Strong pack down from the Bears, keeping the Utes under pressure. Illegally, though, and another Utah penalty. I think that's three, maybe four penalties in a row by the Bears. Perhaps some ill-discipline setting in as changes are made. Looks to be a replacement for Utah, perhaps the return of the yellow card. Instead, looks to be a change with Sam Belcher's afternoon being done as Warmer continues to work his way deep into Cal territory from his right boot. Turn again with a throw in. Trying to work the middle pod. Gathered neatly by Ian Tapuililu. Utah keeping things tight with a pick and jam. Hoping to chew up some Cal defense, maybe release some space for their back line to attack. The open side flanker churn goes himself. Now Warmer. Some misdirection in the midfield from Utah. Skill breakdown, unfortunately. The knock on. Now scrum down for California.
bounce around, let's go.
Just under 6 minutes left in today's action. Bears at home again next 2 weeks in a row as the Arizona Wildcats come to Strawberry Canyon, followed by Army. Dogowitz to Thomasine. MacPhail doing well to put the ball through his hands, finding DeBeer. DeBeer again, another strong carry. Good impact sub is DeBeer. Cal finds their way to the Utah 22. Stephen Finneroli seeing something he doesn't like, perhaps radioed in from Matt Hederman, his AR. A clean out looks to be high from Cal, earning a Utah penalty. Looks to be a good fit from Wormer. It's a great kick from Wormer. Thomasine tried to keep it in. Slow to get up. Looks to be nothing more than a cramp. With a Utah line out about 30 meters out of their try line. Schroeder again disrupting the line of touch. It's been a menace for Utah today. A thorn in Utah's side. Hugo Schroeder, the sophomore from Brisbane. Of course, his first start today. Playing well. Disrupting the line, the defensive line of touch. As Utah gets things restarted from the scrum, an untidy scrum and a strong tackle from what looks to be Dom Paga, the replacement back rower. A knock on from Utah. And an attacking scrum for the Bears. Thomasine getting things going, as he so frequently has today. Thomasine to replacement fly half Jack Casey. MacPhail to Newell, finding some space. We've got Kirsten on his outside, putting the ball on his left boot to be chased by DeBeer and Cal Leibowitz. Utah under a tremendous amount of pressure, putting the ball on their foot. Gathered by Malone. MacPhail into Joe Kirsten. Jack Casey down the right-hand side to dot down for his second try since coming on this afternoon.
California.
Interesting run of play there for the Bears. Good space from Newell. Good chip ahead. Plenty of pressure put on the Utah defense as they gathered that kick. Miles Malone did well to recover the kick, put the ball through his hands, find some space. Jack Casey with his third attempt from virtually the exact same location. Hard to feel bad for the guy. Two of those three were his own try. We'll see if third time's a charm from this right-hand touchline. Breeze has subsided here in Berkeley. Again going with the low kick. Again leaving 2 points wanting. 112-6 in favor of the Bears. 60 seconds remain in today's contest. Ian Warmer now opting for the resport down the middle of the field. Scrum half Thomasine unloads to his fullback Jack Newell. Oliver Newell, excuse me, keeping the ball alive. Cal Leibowitz bringing some pace onto the ball. Thomasine into Cade Crist. Finds his replacement back rower, Dom Paga. Casey now to Fell. Numbers abound for the Bears. DeBeer getting on the outside of his defender. And over for DeBeer. That'll likely do it for the Bears today. DeBeer, a recent addition to the Cal squad this spring. The Joburg boy doing well to get on the outside of his defender. Dotting down for the final action of today's match. Jack Casey will try and add two more as the Bears put in a strong demonstrative performance against conference foes, the University of Utah. Casey finding his way to 2 points in the end, bringing the final tally in today's action, 119-6 in favor of the Bears. That's the final whistle from referee Stephen Finneroli. Thank you for joining us this afternoon here at Wetter Rugby Field in Berkeley. The Bears will continue their home stretch of games the next 2 weekends to face off against the Arizona Wildcats next weekend for homecoming, followed by Army coming to Strawberry Canyon March 4th in a fortnight. We will hope to see you all soon.
With the varsity match to follow at 1 p.m. We are excited to host our annual National Champions Reunion celebrating our alumni from the championship teams of 1983, 1988, 1993, 1998, 2008, and 2013
sevens and 15 national champions. Drive carefully, and as always,
go Bears!
I do not. You know, actually, just
for whatever reason, it just kind of worked out. So, I'm gonna try to do the game next week in college and see what shows up. I'm gonna talk to
I'll just see you guys.
Bye, friend.